Hello, my friends. This is going to be a short recording for a good friend of mine who I shall refer to as Ms. Rose or Simon's mother, so that I don't have to use her real name. And these are things that matter to her and to me. This is also for her nephew, whom I have met, who is also a big fan of Minecraft. I am going to be showing off a couple of builds. Hopefully the people in chat behave themselves enough that I don't have to edit something they say, because that's a possibility. Yeah, let's do this. Let's get to showing you HeroCraft. So this is my basement. It's obviously unfinished. This is copper and iron. We have an iron farm on server, so iron is plentiful, and I thought this would be something that I could never ever do in a normal game, because I would never have an iron farm that was good enough that I would like literally build with it. But this is a pretty floor, and then it's gonna be brick and some other buildings, and this is my lava farm. I love my lava farm. I primarily used lava in the past as the primary source, so I will show you my other little room deep in the halls of my mine, which is my favorite. So this is my bee sanctuary. I only have 4 hives right now. Let's see if I can breed some more babies. No, they went in. I can't breed with one. Sorry, you go back away. I'm gonna collect some honey real quick while I'm here, cause I can't help myself. I love the sweet. It's good stuff. It goes well with peaches. Yeah, so it's not completely finished. This whole area, this water area was natural, but most of it was just stone, like this part. So I added dirt and grass, which you can see not all the dirt has grown grass yet. And some glow vines, and then I'll be adding more. It's funny because the bees will help the glow vines grow. So this was like one little thing at the top, but because it's like in the center, the bees fly up high at all the time. So this thing grew really fast, like really, really fast. So I hope to have like glow vines all over the place. Okay, so. I built in a dark oak forest. I've got a fireworks to fly home. All right. I built in a dark oak forest. Oop, sleeping time. So I have lots of dark oak to build with. So this is primarily the wood type that I use in my builds. This is bone blocks, because they have that beautiful cream color to them. And then this is sort of my area around my house. Very wooded. Planning on doing like a garden going down this way at some point. Lots of pretty mushrooms to steal the mushrooms from. There's plenty of bees over in this little area here too, because birch forests do really well with bees. But I just sort of have like a mountaintop, and then you'll see the tavern later and you'll know where all the dark oak came from, because I had to clear this whole top part. So let's go. Oh, these are my pets. So this is a skeletal horse that my friend's on, and this is a follower animal. So this is HeroCraft, which means it is part of a interactive stream on Twitch. KojiroMC is the owner. Doublemint Ben is one of the moderators on server. I pay $5 a month to be on the server. Vaughn is a VIP for many, 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 many reasons. I won't go into all of them. I just know that she's insanely supportive of the Twitch channel, and I just in like a ton of different ways. She's pretty amazing. Tempsy and Sea Doggy, I've made friends with since we've been on server. I made friends with them when we were in chat, but like we're all a lot closer now that we're playing together. So we're gonna go into the basement through the Nether portal, and then we can go see the other builds because I haven't worked on home a lot because I've been doing other stuff. This is the top of the Nether roof, which can be interesting to load. And we have pathways that lead us to other people's bases. This is my base, Chalice Puma's Way. This is, this is Tempsy Joy with Zombie Cleo's head. This is our spawn portal, which we will go into now because this is where the builds are. So this is, if you join HeroCraft, this is where you'll show up. KojiroMC, that's the owner of the server. These are his mods. We have Dumberlin Ben, we have Ninja, Ahsoka Tano, and Richard Thornton. And then the first couple of people who joined server got special boxes. So part of the special boxes was this elytra and these boots, which are crazy, 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 crazy useful. This pickaxe, which is the precious pickaxe. Fortune 10 is insane. The vast majority of the materials that I've gotten for this beautiful build, which is the tavern, have been because of Fortune 10. This is Vana's head. That's my head. I can show you the skin that I'm wearing. Boop, 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 boop. Sort of a witchy skin. I had somebody make for me. I commissioned it. It's great. So this is our first floor. We have our fireplace, and this is our bar with chairs. We have little washing thingies, and then barrels, which are actually useful. I actually have some stuff in the barrels. I have some potions and some honey bottles, and then some more water bottles that I'm waiting for. And then we have actually chairs that you can sit in because they have minecarts in them. So you could actually, that's the most important thing to me, that these actually be sittable. We have a second floor that we'll go up shortly. This is my kitchen and my burb. Hello to my burb. I don't have a name tag on him yet because I haven't had name tags yet. My sinks, my refrigerator. These are raw materials. These are prepared food. And this is a community building, so anybody can come in here and grab food if they need to. And I got my brew stands and stuff. And it's my little sort of a diary thing. And then I have various foods, ingredients stored up. We have a... a communal garden right outside, so it's been pretty easy just to sort of grab food and bring it in here and either cook with it or whatever we need to do. So we do have a basement, but I didn't build the basement, so I don't know if I should show it to you or not. It's really cool, but I'll ask. So this is our second floor. These are the like hotel style rooms the tavern has. I have a little window you can see down into the kitchen. So these rooms, this is the orange room, this is taken, this is Vanna's room. She's added a couple of little things to it. We have a bed, chests, table. She's got a little window. She can see over that. And then this is the bathroom. There's two of them upstairs. It's like a little loofah, a sink, a bathtub, a shampoo bottle, a shower head. And then this is Tempsey's room, which is just the basics in it, except for the ender chest. So this is a room that's not taken. So this is what you would typically find in any of the rooms upstairs. You've got a bed, you've got a hook for your coat, you've got an empty chest, you've got a plant, some shelves, a bottle that matches the color. You've got some water bottles, like in a hotel room when you'd get like water in your thing. This is the double suite, and right now it's occupied by skeletal horses, which I need to make a stable for them at some point. So this would be room black, where you would have a black handle and a black bed and a barrel and a chest. So these rooms aren't taken, but they're available for somebody on server if they felt like coming in. This is room brown with a brown candle, a brown bed, and so on and so forth. And purple room, we have plant, bottle, bed, chest, barrel, shelf, hook. This is our lovely roof, which probably was the most boring part of building the entire thing, just because it's just so many blocks to place that are exactly the same, you know. And then this is our staff utility closet. We've got a sink and a table and some barrels for supplies. Yeah. So these blocks here are, of course, the bone blocks again. I really enjoy that sort of creamy color with the sort of gradation on the sides. Definitely reminds me of like plaster. And then we've got some little shelves with some little plants. I love my little shelves. Some extra details in the corners. This is stripped dark oak, but like the alternated, so they're like checker block, which I've seen people do before and it's super cool. Some more shelves with some more plants and stuff, and barrels for storage. This is Vanna's area that she made. I actually put these up here, so I'm going to take them down. So this is like a dance floor, sort of kind of a club area. She does have a disc that she is absolutely in love with, which we play when we come down here, the couple of times we've come down here. So she's got the crazy lit floor and some tables, which are just pistons extended. She's got a wither rose, which is really cool. And aren't the glowhead heads just so adorable? Oh my god, this is a glow squid head. They're so cute! With the little things on the sides. Oh, that's just adorable. An Enrod. An Eliminian. Oh, I think she did fantastic. Like, I think this feel, like, you can walk into this and you would never question what it is, because you absolutely know this is like a club. And that's the mark of a great builder, when somebody can come in and be like, oh yeah, no, that's totally a thing. So that's how I feel about Vaughn's building. Gotta put these back up though. People know it's blocked off. Alright, so that's not finished yet. She's still got some more details she wants to add to that. But pretty much I'm done with the tavern. I think the only thing that I would change about it, if I wanted to change something, would be the edges. I'll show what I mean. So on the edges of the roof, You'll see sometimes where people will put like a stone stair step on the side so that it gives a really beautiful edging to the side of the building. And that's probably the only thing that I would fix. I didn't look really good on like the smaller things, but it probably would make this feel a little bit more finished on these sides. It's probably the only thing I would change. This is our next build. And I say R because I'm going to be doing the outside and then Vaughn is going to be doing the inside. This is the block palette that I put out for people to vote on if they wanted the lighter blue or the darker blue. This is going to be the post office. So we've got all these boxes that are just sort of sitting here. And they're donations for the server or for projects, help wanted, you know, community will take what you want. So on and so forth. So they're community boxes, but it just looks kind of ugly. So we would build the post office where people would have mailboxes where you could drop stuff off in if you wanted to leave something for them and they weren't on server. There would be like a donation section in the back. So let's go through. So this is how I'm imagining it. So you've got the door, you walk in. You've got like a community board or a personal request board. We would have the community mailboxes on this side. So that any of the community members could get stuff left for them when they're on server, if they're off server. And then Kojiro and his mods would have mailboxes and stuff over on this side. Because obviously people are more likely to leave Kojiro something because he's the owner and he does a lot of massive projects. So we would have more chests for him just so that people could actually fit all the stuff in that they wanted to. And then this would be like community project donation boxes where you would leave stuff like these boxes where people have left materials to build the post office. So if we had another community project, then it would be left here. So the middle section is going to be a little taller than the outlying areas. I thought maybe I might even do like a dome glass on top. So the middle section would just sort of be this beautiful sort of height to it. And then this would be just smaller because they're just going to be mailboxes. So this is the next project. So I didn't outline the tavern like this. I just started building, I guess. But this is a utility sort of a thing. So I had to think about what I wanted it to do first. So, you know, I had to think of, okay, well, how are we going to use the thing? We're going to use it for mailboxes, but they're going to be different sections. So like mailboxes for the community, mailboxes for the mods, and then donation boxes for like larger projects. So this is why it's shaped like this, because I wanted there to be purposeful wings for things, and then maybe the community board in the middle, which we'll see. That's why these have question marks. Like I'm not sold on the idea, and I'm not unsold on the idea. I think the community has to decide whether or not they want that and if they're going to use it. So I don't normally frame stuff for my builds. I just sort of go for it. But since this is going to be something that the community will use, it had to be more purposeful. People had to vote on, you know, is this a good shape? Is this a good size for what the community needs? You know, are these block palettes something that people are excited about? Like, I think of post offices and I think of this blue. Just because I'm an American. And there are a lot of non-Americans. Like, Vana is not American on the server. And they may have a different idea of what color means post office. So we'll vote on it and we'll talk about that. I guess I'll show you around a couple other places. This is Vana's jail because Vana is often bad. Oh my god. There's like stop blocks. We can't even get to the thing and look in anymore. Oh, they must have done something. Yeah, so Vanna has to be put in jail quite often because she's a pesky, pesky monster. This is Watcher Arcade's creeper. Oh, you can't even get near it anymore. Oh, that's because they kept putting in a boat and moving it. Listen, this server is a little chaotic. This is Vanna's head. Vanna vibes the everything service. Rename a paper, leave your request. If I agree to the job is excessive, reserves the right to refusing jobs too big or too strenuous. We'll try my best. Yeah. Uh-oh. They must be doing a raid. Because they're dying to monsters. What is this? What is this? Mod storage? Are we storing mods here? Oh, okay. How are you? You don't even have anything. How are you? Jim Bob Slim. This is spawn, so it's spawn protected, which means you can't do anything here unless you're a mod. So I can't break any of these bricks. I can't change any of this stuff. The server owner is very much into making farms. So, I love it. So we've got a slime farm if you follow the green. We've got an industrial district if you follow the orange. There's a witch farm and a food farm if you follow the magenta. My build is this way. Vericariously 3D's is this way. Kojiro's base is this way. Temsi's and Vanna's is that way. So let's take a look. So this is our streamer's base. And he's been streaming from this server for a few, yeah, it's been a few months at this point. I'm trying to remember. Often enough that because he's got an interactive stream, which includes TNT and creepers. This was his base at one point in time because we kept blowing his stuff up. But eventually he moved himself into an area underground to try to prevent having those issues, but we're still really, really good at exploding his stuff, let's be honest. Which is why his stuff, even down here, is covered in obsidian. These are his bees. His bees! Which actually, those are probably the parents of some of the bees that I have, because I put a thing in here and then bred a bunch and then took it back out. His cows are gone again. Oh, he's probably not happy about that. Yeah, so his stream is very, very chaotic because we have the ability to blow stuff up and so on and so forth. Oh, no. Which does happen pretty often. Not gonna lie, I've also been there, done that, so on and so forth. Yeah, but this is HeroCraft. It's been going since the first of the year. We started on January 1st. So, 18 days. But the server's been running a little longer because Kojiro's been doing his stream from here. This is his villager trading. I spent a little time here this weekend to get some stuff I needed. What in the world? That's funny. Oh my god, that's funny. Sean is not the only chaotic one in the server. Sea Doggy is almost as bad, if not as bad. I am not used to flying with an Elytra. I've never used one in any other previous games. Just because I've never really gotten to the point of an Elytra. So I'm still learning how to fly. The nether is down there. And then this is his smaller farm district. We have a larger one elsewhere. Basically obliterated most of the sand in this area because we're all building with the sand. But this is his iron farm, which I have used a lot. Partly for the poppies, because I was making money a lot of them. And this is sugarcane farm, which we need because we use rockets, and you make paper out of sugarcane and rockets out of paper and dynamite. Or gunpowder. Gunpowder, I mean gunpowder. So you can see how many rockets I've used just flying around. Yeah, so this is HeroCraft. I'm gonna mosey on back to my base, which is where I need to be at the end of this section. It might be the wrong way. This is Tempsy Joy's little area. She's got a cute little area. But I didn't ask permission, so we're not gonna do that. What am I doing? Whose base is this? Doesn't appear to be marked. I'm super curious. Why is there explosion sounds? What did I find? What in the world? Okay, I don't know. I don't know where I am. I don't know what this place is. We're just gonna back out slowly. Could be nothing. Could be a secret. I'm gonna get lost now. Happens when you're on a streamer server. Random things show up. Follow this back to the... the hub. Here we are. Here we're back at the hub. And from the hub... I think my base is this way. This is the other way. I'm wrong. You see how many rockets I use when I'm wrong. This is my way to my base. Boop. And now we're back in my little unfinished basement, which is super pretty, even without the walls in yet. Does this feel like a pizza place? Maybe this feels like a pizza place. I'm okay with it feeling like a pizza place. Kind of want to know if that's what it feels like. Maybe I spent too much time in Chicago. Or like... bread brick means pizza. So glad I took care of you guys. Yep, you don't have to get rained on. My house getting rained on. Because I don't have a roof on it yet. Alright. This is my original skin. See, I changed it up quite a bit.